draw you in. Watch the moments unfold. Spark a dream that we're meant to follow. Setting out for a new tomorrow.
In all the glory,
we're changed by the way we live every day. Just look up and reach to the sky.
We all have the courage to fly.
Happily Ever After is an exciting new nighttime spectacular that is designed for Walt Disney World's Magic Kingdom. It is an experience unlike any other, and it brings together kind of a wonderful kiss goodnight for our guests, a way to celebrate all the different characters and the experiences that they've seen in the park throughout the day with fireworks and lasers, lighting, and an incredible new score. The show really follows the hero's journey, and it kind of takes us on all of those different milestones that we experience, from a dream to going on the journey, to meeting friends, to falling in love, to facing adversity and overcoming challenge, and hopefully to triumph and to finding our own happily ever after.
Because what's so exciting is what you were talking about, right, of the tentacles physically wrapping around.
I'm really excited about this project. I think it's going to be one of the most spectacular things at Walt Disney World, and we really want this show to have all of the heart and the majesty that Wish has had, to be able to experience all new songs and to do it with new technology, to use projection, to incorporate lasers, to have new lighting, and to be able to paint with fireworks in the sky. As much as you love Wishes, definitely hang on, because we do take the great things, we make them even better, and we're really excited about this project.
To begin, let the wonder take hold.
With this wonderful original opening song called Happily Ever After, that really talks about the journey that we all take in life and the way that we look at finding our own happily ever after.
Feel it draw you in, watch the moments unfold.
You know, my happily ever after is being able to do what I love every day of my life. This is part of my happily ever after, being a part of this experience, you know, being a part of this thing that's going to be immortalized that millions of people will see over the course of however long it exists at the park.
Spark a dream that we're meant to follow, setting out for a new tomorrow.
I think this song is so special to me because I wasn't always a musician. I was working on cars and going to school 4 years ago. And I took a leap of faith, which is what Disney is. It's about believing in something, not because the reasons are telling you to, but because you want to, because your body, your heart, and your soul is telling you to.
That, I think, is so perfectly summed up in this song. It's magical. It truly is. It's magical.
Disney's so good at storytelling. And it's so good at inspiring, but at the end of the day, it doesn't mean anything until you find a way to apply it to your own life. And I think that's the wondrous part of the whole song, of the whole fireworks experience, is that moment when you realize, well, what's yours? Like, what's your dream?
My favorite part of the song is the finale. It's the Happily Ever After reprise. And there's a moment, the lyrics go, we're changed by the way we live every day.
Look up and reach to the sky.
My favorite Disney film of all time is Peter Pan. I think the sentiment of lyrically what is being structured and how it takes off and lifts into this incredible finale where you hear, you know, this amazing 90-piece gospel choir. It's so big and it's so beautiful, and I think the sentiment behind it makes it even more special. And then, you know, add the fireworks and the amazing animation. I think that that's going to be a moment that everybody remembers. I'm so excited.
Ever After is really synonymous with so many of those amazing Disney films that we love, and it's a great way to kind of celebrate the journey that a lot of our characters take. One of the best parts of the project has been working with some of the original artists from feature animation and seeing them create animations just for this show that are going to live on the castle.
There's some ideas that they wanted to have in the story that didn't exist in the films, and so they asked us to come on and animate some new animation of these characters.
As artists, you're always kicking yourself or saying, gee, I wished I could go back and do something or make a change. And so they actually have the chance to go back and revisit a character.
It's super exciting. I mean, for me, it's a thrill because Aladdin was the first film I worked on. And to come back and be animating Aladdin again after 25 years and feeling that same kind of excitement and thrill I did when I first got here, you know, this is a dream come true to be a Disney animator, you know.
It's just fun to play with these characters in a completely different context than the original film, but certainly harken back to the original film. One thing that I wanted to do in this sequence was at Ursula's most dramatic moment in the original film, she's underlit. So we're gonna go for that same kind of underlit look on her, so she's highly dramatic as she rises up and her tentacles wind around the various castle turrets.
And then I think that these characters, the stories and the journeys that they've all gone through that we see in the show, will remind people that, you know, Happily Ever After still can exist. We can still have our hopes and dreams and still hope for that Happily Ever After.
Happily Ever After is our newest spectacular at Magic Kingdom. This show takes our audience on an incredible journey in search of Happily Ever After. The show is supported by a beautiful musical score that we just recorded in London.
Overall, really good. We just need to tighten up a little bit rhythmically.
Happily Ever After takes the listener on a musical journey.
The story of friendship, the story of perseverance, of overcoming obstacles, and then ultimately victory. It was fantastic to arrange this and come together here with the orchestra.
I think what's been best about this project is just this collaborative process we've had in working with the team that's doing the visuals. It's been inspiring. The stuff they're doing on the castle is something I've never seen before. That's been an inspiring thing in terms of the music.
Right now, animators are finishing up the drawings that will be placed upon the castle, bringing our characters to life in a new and exciting way.
It's just fun to play with these characters in a completely different context than the original film, but certainly harken back to the original film.
And our pyrotechnics team is designing a show that will light up the sky like it's never been seen before.
I think the emotions for me is all those things that you felt the first time you came to Magic Kingdom. You know, the wonder and the excitement, sometimes a little scary, but ultimately just a profound sense of magic. There's really no other way to put it, and this is a magical show.
The show is going to blow everyone away. We cannot wait to share this with our audiences later this year. So the visuals that we're seeing on the castle that our design team is working on is truly magical. You know, it's really important to come out here and take a look at our visuals that we've been talking about and seeing it actually displayed upon the castle. We get to check to see if the storytelling is really working for us and make it come to life.
Growing up as a kid, seeing the castle in Disney and being able to kind of work off of that as the canvas to start from, you know, it's not just paper, it's not just a cell, it's the physical structure of this castle as our starting point, is a really powerful medium to be using.
I think it works though.
It totally does, yeah. Happily Ever After is unlike any castle show you have ever seen. When we started this project, we wanted to challenge ourselves to find a way to make Happily Ever After unique, to approach projection mapping in a way that has never been done before. And I think we've done that. I think we have looked for opportunities to really push the boundaries of what the surface can contain and how, what it can become.
Most of these moments where you see somebody shoot something ties to a laser and then ties to a firework.
We have so tightly worked with the other disciplines to integrate all the technologies together. It's not just projection, it's not just lights, it's not just fireworks. We're working day to day with one another as we develop our content so that there's an integration between what the fireworks are doing and what the castle is doing. So that as the audience experiences the show, there's a cohesiveness. In that way, I think that we're able to push the boundaries that have never been pushed before.
It's been remarkable to see all of these different elements that are working simultaneously, but really coming together and creating something that is so special. True collaboration is really the magic of the show.
So we are here in London at Air Studios to record a 75-piece orchestra for the new show, Happily Ever After at Magic Kingdom.
Happily Ever After is really meant to be the kiss goodnight, the kind of final moment where you and your family gather together to watch this experience. And the music is truly at the heart of everything. It's the script, it's the emotion, it's the thing that guides us through.
Yeah, great.
Yeah.
Love it.
With this show, it's really a wide range of emotions. We've got some beautiful stuff that's just very sensitive to, you know, we've got this banging section we call adversity, which is where the heroes are going through the adversity on their journey. So, you know, it can be loud and exciting, wonderful and loving. We've got another section, which is the friends section. It's just constantly changing and moving.
What's so wonderful about this show is taking what the world I love, which is music, and the world of Disney music, the power of Disney music.
How do you put all of these themes that were written at different times by different composers together in one piece of music? And that's really how we feel about this whole show, is that it's one, very much one continuous piece of music that you go on this journey for.
As our audience watches the show, I want them to feel the same emotions that our characters are feeling. I want them to feel this sense of adventure. I want them to have moments where they dream. I want them to reflect on their own dreams. I want them to feel love. You know, I want them to laugh. These are all the emotions that we're going to be conveying, both visually and, of course, musically.